Olá pessoal! Hello everyone! I'm excited to have you here today. I'm Laura and this is my channel Portuguese with Laura. And today I'm gonna teach you all you need to know about the present continuous in Portuguese with music. Before we get started, if you're new here, make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any of my future videos. Also, follow me on other social media too. I'm there by Sing Brazilian. Like I said, we're gonna be learning about the present continuous in Portuguese today. And in order to do that, we will be using the song Eu Tô Tentando by Kid Abelha. First, I'm going to play the song for you and I want you to try to identify the words, the expressions, the verbs, the stuff you already know from this song, okay?
Eu tô tentando largar o cigarro, eu tô tentando remar meu barco, eu tô tentando armar um barraco, eu tô tentando não cair no buraco, eu tô tentando tirar o atraso, eu tô tentando te dar um abraço, eu tô penando pra driblar o fracasso, eu tô brigando pra enfrentar o cagaço.
So, in this song, they repeat many times this expression here, this sentence here. Eu tô tentando. It's even the name of the song, right? Eu tô tentando. What does it mean? It means I am trying. Eu tô tentando. I am trying. So this is the basis of the present continuous tense in Portuguese. Okay? Let's see here. So, to form the present continuous tense in Portuguese, we need a subject, then we need the verb estar, and then we need the gerund. What is this gerund? In Portuguese, we say gerúndio. So, this here is gerúndio. É o gerúndio. How can we use this? Like, we can use for the present continuous and in some other situations that can be a little bit different from English. But that's not what we're talking about here. So, what is this gerúndio? It's when we put the verb in English. It would be when you put the verb in the ing form. The ing. So, for example, eu tô tentando, I am trying in English. Trying. See here, when you use this ing in English, we use the ndo. In Portuguese, the N-D-O, N-D-O, in Portuguese, see? Here's the verb in the infinitive, tentar, to try, tentar. In the gerúndio, tentando, in English, trying, see? Another example here, andar, to walk. In the gerúndio, andando. In English, walking, walking. Comer, to eat. Comendo, eating. Dormir, to sleep. Dormindo, sleeping. Okay? So, it's a pattern here. And now, let's go deeper here in the presente contínuo, our topic for today. So, presente contínuo. In Portuguese, this can have other names, okay? You can also find this as presente progressivo, okay? Presente progressivo. So, you can find this with different names, but the idea is the same. So, like I said, we're going to be forming the presente contínuo by using a subject that can be hidden or not. Then, we're going to use the verb estar, conjugated accordingly to that subject, and then we're gonna use the gerund, the verb in the gerúndio. Okay? Very good. So now, I separated here many examples from this song. This song is very rich in examples for this verbal tense, okay? So the first one here. Eu tô tentando largar o cigarro. Eu tô tentando largar o cigarro. What does it mean? I'm trying to ditch the cigarettes. You know, I'm trying to quit smoking. Cigarro is the cigarette, but the general meaning here would be I'm trying to quit smoking. So, eu tô tentando. And see here, the right conjugation for the verb estar here would be eu estou. But the informal way is to say eu tô. Okay? It's not correct. It's not grammatically correct. Okay? The conjugation is eu estou. But in everyday life, we say eu tô. Eu tô. Okay? And in the song, he is saying eu tô. See here why it's so good to learn from songs. You know, because in these songs, you can see how people actually speak, how we actually use this language in our daily life. You know, you see that in our daily life, we do not say eu estou tentando. No, we say eu tô tentando. Eu tô tentando. And you cannot find this like in normal books, you know, in normal resources. It has to be something that is focused on this daily life, you know. And music is a very good tool for that. So, more examples from the song here. Eu tô penando para driblar o fracasso. This has like a little slang, something that is not formal, you know. So, eu tô penando. The verb here is penar. It means like to struggle. Okay, so eu tô penando. I am struggling. Para driblar o fracasso. Para driblar o fracasso. To dodge failure. So fracasso is failure. Okay? Eu tô brigando para enfrentar o cagaço. I'm fighting to face the fear. The word for fear is medo. The most common, the most direct word for fear is medo. But cagaço is a very informal word for fear. Okay, very, very informal. So here he's like trying to fight the fear. He is fighting to face the fear. Okay, so brigando is the gerúndio for the verb brigar, to fight. Okay, next one. Eu tô fincando meus pés no chão. I'm like planting my feet on the ground. Eu tô fincando. I'm gonna stay still here. Eu tô treinando pra ser campeão. I am practicing. So, treinar is to practice something. So, eu tô treinando pra ser campeão. Okay? To practice can also be praticar, okay? So, treinar is almost a synonym to praticar, okay? Can be training too. Eu tô chutando pra marcar gol. Eu tô chutando. I am kicking. So, chutar is to kick. I am kicking. Eu tô chutando. Para marcar gol, to score a goal, okay? This is vocabulary for football. Para futebol, like we say. So, gol is a goal, goal. And marcar gol is like, it's how you say. So, to score a goal, marcar gol. The next here. Eu tô vivendo de rock and roll. So, I am living off rock and roll. Okay? So, eu tô vivendo. I am living. Let me give you another example with this verb here. Eu tô vivendo no Brasil. I am living in Brazil now. You want to sound even more natural? Say, eu tô morando no Brasil. When I use this, I give the idea that something is happening like right now, at this exact moment. Okay, so you can use this when you want to give the idea that at this moment you're doing this. Maybe in the future you won't, okay? Or if you want to give this idea of now, for example. Eu estou aprendendo português agora. I am learning Portuguese now. Okay? Or if someone comes into your room, you can say, no, eu estou estudando. I am studying. Leave me alone. Eu estou estudando. So to give this idea of right now. Okay? And I put more examples here. So, like I said, eu estou estudando. I want to ask you now. Você está aprendendo português? Are you learning Portuguese? So, see here that the conjugation for the verb estar is very important, okay? And this conjugation changes according to the person, according to the subject. So, eu estou. It's not estoy, that's Spanish. Eu estou. Você está. You are. Você está aprendendo português? Are you learning Portuguese? Ele está trabalhando. He is working. Ela está gostando dele. She is liking him. So see here, I'm using different conjugations for different personal pronouns. Okay? If you do not know this, if you do not remember this, you can check a class I already released here about the verbs ser and estar in Portuguese, okay? So, you have to conjugate appropriately, and the next verb you just put in the ing, that is NDO in Portuguese, okay? Simple like this. Next example. Nós estamos pensando em nos mudar de país. So, we are thinking about moving to another country, okay? So, nós estamos, we are, nós estamos pensando, pensando. Eles estão passando férias no Brasil. They are spending their vacation in Brazil, okay? Eles estão. See here the conjugation. Eles estão passando férias no Brasil. Alright? So, we saw many examples here. We saw many from the song, okay? I want that after the class, you listen to the song carefully, okay? You can listen to every line and then pause and then repeat what they're saying. You will definitely memorize the pattern for the present continuous, okay? Eu tô tentando, eu tô penando, eu tô brigando. And for you, when you are speaking, the most important conjugation to know is this one, in the first moment, eu tô, because it's something you're talking about yourself. Then you can learn the conjugation for other people too, and I already showed you here. So, você está. To sound more informal, you can also say, like you say here, eu tô, you can say, você tá. You link here and it becomes like, eles estão. I hope you enjoyed this song and this band. I really like this band, you know, they have many other cool songs. You can look them up. It's Kiji Abelha. If you enjoyed this live class, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. You will be helping me a lot here. I upload new videos every week, so remember to subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet, okay? So you don't miss any of these future videos. See you next time! Até a próxima! Bye! Tchau!